Hey, it's Michael here from EduKids. In this video, we're going to explore the powerful new functions editor feature in our drag and drop block coding editor for Arduino, CodeKit. Functions are like creating your own custom blocks that you can use and reuse, making your code cleaner and more efficient. So let's dive in. As you can see, we are in our CodeKit interface. Now let's create our very own function. Here on the left side, we have the functions flyout. Let's click it and select the option that says new function. You'll see a modal has popped up, which is where we'll design our new function. Here, we can specify the name of our function, its return type, and the parameters it will take. Parameters are like inputs to our function that affect how it behaves. Now, we're going to be making a function that calculates the area of a rectangle, and we'll call it calculateArea. It will take two parameters, which are length and width. And we can create those by pressing the add input, and then we can just type in a name. Now, the return type for this function is going to be integer, because the number we get when we multiply length and width, we want that to be an integer. That's a number type. It's not a string. It's not a Boolean. Yes, no, true, false. It's an integer. Then, the final thing we have to do is select the save button, and look, a new function wrapper block has appeared in our workspace, signifying our newly created function. If we right-click this block, we can see that there are options to create length and width, which were our parameters, and also a calculate area block. But for the moment, we're going to take a look in the variables flyout, because there's two new blocks here that weren't there before. There is a calculate area, which is our basically a block for the function we've just created. So essentially this is our own block, our own custom block. And then we have a return one, which lets us return a specific value. And we're going to be using this later. Now, we want to, with this example, we're going to print the area of a rectangle using our messaging. So we will, in the setup, start our serial, and we'll set that to 9600. And then we're going to loop and forever print the area of our rectangle. So we've got our serial print, and then I'm going to grab our function block, calculate area, and we can stick that in there and use it like we would any other block. You can see that our length and width have two little inputs. And for that, we can grab little number inputs, here we go, drop them in there, and we can calculate length 2, and we'll go width 4. Wonderful. Now, to use our function, we'll need to feed it the values of the length and width parameters. So how do we actually define what our function does? Let's go back to the function wrapper block. In here, we define the body of our function, that is, what it actually does with the inputs we provide. For our calculate area function, we'll need to multiply the length by the width. So we'll need a mathematics block over here. And we can use this simple two operator block. Now we need something to put this in. And what we're gonna do is add this return block. And what this does for a function is if you have a return type, for example, like an integer or a string, you can pass back that value into here. So for example, when we say send calculate area length 2 width 4, that should give us 4 times 2 is 8, so it should send the number 8. And the number that is going to be sent is passed through with the return. And this is going to become more clear in just a moment, but I can right click, select create length, and we now have a block called length. What I can do is put this in one of the slots. We can repeat this for the width, so right click on the function wrapper, select create width, and then we can drag this into the second option, and voila. We are now returning the length and the width, but all we need to do is change this to times. So now we have a working function to calculate the area of a rectangle. Remember, the beauty of functions is that you can reuse them as much as you want, making your code more efficient and organized. Thanks for joining us today. Don't forget to subscribe for more educational videos. Stay curious and keep exploring.